Flufflebuns, welcome back. This is Roxybun, and this is the third and final Dayshift At Freddy's game, which is the third one, and the artwork already looks a lot different. Looks like they put a lot more work into this. If they had, like, someone actually draw pictures instead of just using shitty clip art. So, let's see what we're getting into. So let's start anew. Ah, it's got a middle finger flipping me off. Cool. Would you like to skip the Dave introduction? No, because I've never played this before. I don't know what that means. Oh? What's this? It's a tape player.
Why, hello there, future entrepreneur.
Future entrepreneur. Congratulations on purchasing. That's Dave, old sport. That's purple guy.
And this pizza relocation kit. 1993.
Oh, 1993.
I am your friendly company representative.
Not a child murderer.
Not a child murderer. Freddy's is a chain of fast food joints that span the entire of America. At its prime, Freddy's had over 50 active locations.
They had 51. Most of which Fred were
permanently Shack. Shut down due to a suspicious number of toddlers going missing on our premises. How crazy is that?
That's crazy.
I'm sure glad that I've had nothing to do with any of that.
You can't prove anything.
You, good sir, are a young visionary.
I'm a young visionary who missing my front teeth.
For a hefty fee of $12.50. The first step of setting up a successful Freddy's Pizza joint is to choose a suitable location.
Choosing a location.
And not just any cardboard box will do. Small enough that mysterious giant scuttlers can be in your restaurant undetected. Trust me on that.
Yeah,
one.
This mysterious scuttlers are fucking need disgusting.
Two rooms. A room for dancing in.
Oh, yes, the spring locks.
Don't splurge on buying a location. Also, save yourself a headache and avoid carpet.
Blood won't stain your easy-to-clean hardwood.
Next, you need ingredients for your pizza. The nearest dumpster will do nicely.
The nearest dumpster.
It sounds to have that distinctive Freddy's taste, don't you? Next, you'll need performers. Robots are expensive. So just buy a fat doggo for $20.
Bad doggo.
Call it a fucking day.
Call it a fucking day.
Better yet, fish something out of the trash.
Fish something
out
of the trash.
Don't have to murder any kids that are buffer than you are. Don't put the rabbit's face on a goddamn pizza. Taxation is theft. Don't pay taxes.
Taxation is theft.
Don't drop kids any screaming toddlers. And don't the facts during this show.
Don't blank the facts.
That's all I have for this day.
Don't yiff the
Goodbye,
fox.
Future restaurant owner. And remember, you are the
I am literally immortal
Freddy,
because of a pack that I made with a little bear Dighty, and all I got was this lousy shirt. Oh god, what am I getting into? Freddy Fazbender's Pizza.
Why, hello there, future business owner.
I'm not old sport anymore. Hello there.
Welcome to your new Freddy's location.
Okay.
Like all Freddy's locations, it's
probably
a complete
dump.
What? Rest assured, with enough business savvy antics,
you'll be
you'll
able
be
to
able
afford,
to afford
running water
in
no
time. You Freddy's issued camera panel should now be sent to your restaurant.
What is this game now? Like, it's not like a visual novel like anymore.
Depressing, isn't
it? It is depressing.
Most beginning Freddy's locations have at least two rooms, a dining area, and a safe room.
Yeah, okay.
This is your dining area.
It's my dining
lucky,
area.
You had enough money left over. Buying the place to afford tables.
To afford tables.
What? The kind of lucky fellow would choose to start up at Freddy's location. A.
A.
Don't worry. With time, you can upgrade everything from the floors to the walls.
So this is like a builder game?
Dream big. Think of better mass.
Better mass. Okay, so what are we doing? Well, there's a safe room.
This is your safe room. It's an offhand room where employees
and
can
smoke, complain about you without getting fired.
And put on a horrendous mask on costume.
Okay.
Spring boy suits are hard to come by these days. So, you're probably gonna be serving birthday cake in a bear onesie
in
for a while.
In a bear onesie? Joke's on you, Dave. I just stuck Golden Hetty out into an existing Springlock body.
Fret not though, entrepreneur. Soon enough, you can buy death traps.
Death traps?
And then hire young adults and old teenagers to die
Young
there.
Adults and old teenagers. Isn't that the same thing?
Groovy.
Groovy. So what, okay.
Now, let's draw paperwork.
Paperwork. I
sign
signed
all of it
the
right
contract.
Now.
Burn
you
all of
put it.
It
in it and sign it all later.
Put it
at
in
your
a
leisure.
Pit and burn it all later at your leisure.
Now, first things first. You have a fun ton of big red letters at your disposal.
Okay.
What name are you gonna slap onto your restaurant?
I have to name it? She has a restaurant name. Freddy Fazbender's Pizza. Freddy's House of Pleasure. Freddo's Vile Pepperoni. Uncle Jack's Family Diner. Bear. Let's go with Bear.
Good choice, I'm guessing. Now, we've also included several cut-out Freddy's heads who go above the name of your pizza joint.
Oh, God.
Corporate
didn't
want
me
to
throw
in
this
cut-out. Since we accidentally took it mid-jump while he had a pit in his mouth.
We're definitely going to use that one.
But since I'm the only one here now, I put Fred Bear's head in the damn pile.
Okay.
So, choose wisely.
Whose head is going to appear above my restaurant? Freddy Fazbear, Bonnie the Rabbit, Chica the Chicken, Foxy the Pirate Fox, Fredbear Mid-Chomp.
You just made a partially irrelevant choice.
Oh, cool. Partially irrelevant.
With all of that out of the way, it's time to go outside, put up your tanky bear head, and call this place open.
This is open? Okay.
Goodbye.
Goodbye.
And
remember,
you
are the face of
Freddy
Fazbear's
Pepperoni.
Go outside and open up. Oh, okay, it's WASD. So is this outside? Alright, kittens. Time to... Orange Maniac revives bear-worshipping pizza cult. This is simply the worst possible timeline, concerned local parent. This is breaking news, by the way. I'm an orange maniac. I totally didn't kill any children. In the last two- Cash, not tokens? Amazing. Actual customers have shown up. Good God. If you play your cards right, you'll be able to buy a table next month. Go get suited up and bring cake out to the kids. Ew. What is this? Okay, here we go. Any training tapes, or is it just the- Oh, it's a onesie. It's cake! Lucky for you, you stole a wedding cake 3 months ago. Cakes are too magical to go stale, right? Oh man, that's good. If any kids get food poisoning, just respond to their parents with that. It's cake time, alright. Okay. Here, kid. It's the shooting star! Right. Take the fucking cake. Angry child. I failed. I don't know. 6 p.m. That was it? That was my first day? Dun, 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 dun. Yay! There's no yay? There should be a yay, because it is yay. Alright, let's take this shitty thing off. Oh, phone call. Hello, hello.
Hello, this is the Los Angeles Police Department.
Oh God, what do you want?
Am I speaking to the owner of Bear?
Yes. Yeah, that's me. Yep, we just opened today, officer.
First of all, may we ask for your name, sir?
No. Oh, fuck it. Oh, I have to type it. That is
okay,
my name.
Okay, thanks for that.
You're welcome.
Glad we have that straightened out. We need to ask you another question.
Okay.
Have you heard anything about what happened outside your restaurant today?
Actually, no, I have not. No, what happened?
Basically, a child named Jacob Adams got abducted outside the new Freddy's location at around 5 p.m.
Oh, great.
No witnesses were close enough to fully make out what happened.
Now I have to deal with this shit?
And the reports that we've gotten so far are totally outlandish and
paranormal.
We know that you were inside when it happened, and we're just calling all nearby businesses out of courtesy.
Alright.
Please, be vigilant.
I will.
Something is outside your restaurant, and it has already taken one child away.
What the fuck is
Make
outside
sure
my
to
restaurant?
Lock up tight, and to keep a close eye out.
Sounds creepy. Good luck with that, or I sure will. Thanks, officer.
Good night.
Good night.
Stay safe.
I will. I don't want to be suspicious. So what the fuck is outside my restaurant doing this shit already? I just fucking opened it. It doesn't even have any tables. What's this? Why am I going up north to another location? Okay. Would you like to save your game? Yes. Well, there's a lot of files. I'll overwrite and then head forward.
Why, hello there, future restaurant owner.
Hi.
Look, I'm gonna level with you. I don't know what you're gonna hear these texts in, but all I know, Afton Robotics has closed
Afton
its doors,
Robotics, that
and no new
familiar.
Robots are being made. What? All of that aside, why would you want to spend money on brand new robots when you're just gonna get children's blood and
buffalo wing sauce
a month after purchase? What you should do is cut corners.
Cut corners.
Cutting corners at the cost of customer safety.
At the cost of customer safety.
Why, that's the American,
it's the American dream.
So, here's what you need to do. Grab a phone book and look for the nearest abandoned Freddy's
location.
Oh,
am I going and salvaging this shit?
Most
Fuck.
Of them are abandoned as of me recording this. So, unless they are bulldozed
or burned
down,
you've got easy
pickings. Go to whatever location you can get to. Find your way inside, and then take the most complete robot you can.
Great.
Shoy. Those Shoy? Old things might be
dangerous or haunted.
What? You'll save a fortune.
I'll save money. At the cost of customer safety.
And besides, customers love those fucking things.
Customers love those
Nothing
fucking
beats
things.
80s nostalgia.
Nothing beats 80s nostalgia.
Worry not. Future restaurant owner. If anything goes wrong, you can always just relocate and
change
your
name.
Right? After all, what kind of man buys a Freddy's location and uses their real name? Anyway, that's it for this tape.
Okay.
Goodbye, and remember, you are the funky face of
Freddy. I'm the funky face of Freddy Fazbender's Pepperonery. Fabulous. Boy, it sure is dark here. Well, time to get searching. So what am I doing? I'm sure I'll find more here than I did last time. What would I like to do? Search to the north. What am I looking for? Robotics? What would you like to do? Search or enter the room behind the stage. Maybe there's some shit back there. There's Freddy head. What would you like to do? Inspect withered Freddy. Boy, Freddy just sure seen better days. Salvage him. Salvaging an old robot increases your liability. You know, let's return to the stage because withered Freddy's just a head, and we want to go for the most complete one we can get, right? All right, let's search to the south. Everything's so dark. This is a dining area. This is creepy as hell, actually. Search to the south from here. What do we got? The south-facing corridor has been blocked off with a pile of rubble from a collapsed wall. Has someone been here since I last have? What would you like to do? Go to the west. Who's this? Is this Freddy? What would you like to do? Inspect Toy Freddy. He is in poor condition and is missing a leg and an eye. Leave him be. Search to the east. I don't know if I really want to take any of these because they're kind of yikes. Okay, the east? Did I go to the east or the west? I don't fucking remember. Oh no, we are not taking balloon fucker. But we can inspect him. Come on. Surely even you don't want a one-legged BB. Leave him be. Search to the north. Ooh, I don't know if I want you. What would you like to do? Inspect Spring Freddy. Wow, and to think you once wore this thing for a living. Strangely enough, someone seems to have repaired it since you've last seen it. Salvage him! Sure. You've decided to take Spring Freddy back with you. You are free to leave through the dining area, or you can explore this location some more. Let's look around a little more. So let's go to the east again. I think they had like another direction to go. Because I went north. Let's see if I can... West. Go west. Oh, we're just back here. Let's just leave with Spring Freddy. What the fuck? Oh. I've got what I came for. It's time to go. Very well. What's done is done. You say goodbye to the Freddy's Bakersfield location for the last time and drag Spring Freddy through the window. Tomorrow is another day. How do I save my game? Okay. Oh, so we're going to all of the... We're going to the Denver location where I used to work. Lovely. Okay. This game is different than the other two, I can tell you that much. Let's go in here. This is where I originally... Oh. It's my house. Is this a cutscene or is this something I'm gonna play? You have one thing left to do tonight. Go to your workshop. It's a sound of silence. Hello, darkness, my old friend. Okay. Is my workshop upstairs? This was Peter and Caroline's room. You've kept this door locked since they passed away. Who are Peter and Caroline? Who these pictures are of, maybe. There's a lady with a doggo. Let's see. A picture of Dee and Sparky, your childhood dog. Hold on a second. Let me go back down. It's not letting me... It's a portrait of the Kennedy family from before all this madness started. It's a portrait of Peter's recently deceased dog, Sparky, too. Am I in someone else's house? There's Peter and Caroline from before Peter's accident. What's this red thing? This is the rug that Peter's dog used to sleep on. It's kind of sad. But let's see, who's in here? It may be late, but you know that there's something you need to take care of first. You can sleep later. Okay, that's my room. Understood. So let's go here. What's this? She's up and running. It's time. This is your last chance to find their souls. What? Your last chance at redemption. Your last chance to give those lost souls their happiest day. So the dead kids, I'm guessing. You have to go inside. Oh boy. Minigame time. I think. Here we are. Wherever this is. I guess you'll just have to take a look around. The Flipside is a hostile place. Save often. Use X or escape to bring up the menu screen. Save. File 2. Alright. The Flipside. So I'm in the Flipside. Oh, there's a map at the bottom. Okay, so this is Freddy's location. I'm just... There's Bonnie. Freddy. I'm just saving off and like it's telling me to. Hello, old sport. It's Dave. Hi.
Old sport?
Yes.
Is that you?
It is me. Dave?
You know, old sport. I never thought I'd see you here.
Why not?
Since you're soulless and...
I'm soulless and all? What is this place? Where am I?
Okay, time to spill the beans. Right now, we're standing in the realm known as the Flipside.
So the Flipside.
It's a place where dreams come to die, and lost souls eat pizza and stuff.
Lost souls eat pizza and stuff? Okay, go on.
Basically, you've left your timeline and come to a place outside of your own reality. The Flipside.
Okay.
The Flipside.
The Flipside.
As it is currently known, is a place where lost souls retreat to.
I had no idea that was possible.
You didn't. You yes the damn fox.
You
yes
the damn fox
about
12 times while it was haunted.
Please
tell me that
you
didn't actually think that a sentient child's mind was inside that fox while you were doing the two. What? No, of course I didn't actually think that. But what if the fox consented?
Good lord.
Good lord.
Maybe a serial killer.
Maybe a serial killer, but that's just wrong. And casual child murder isn't? I'm sorry, continue.
The flip side allows souls to remain intact, even if a soul's vessel commits an atrocity in the name of vengeance.
Okay. I don't get what you mean.
Okay. Stuff a night gods into suits. Buy another kids. Being called
Furbo the Blue Testicle.
That's too much for a child's mind to bear.
That's too much for a child's mind to bear.
All the time. Souls tend to retreat to the flip side.
Okay.
And as a result, their vessels become more feral.
They're feral, which is why you're here. Good question. Why are you here?
I've been here for years, to be honest. Or some form of me has, at least. Here's a word of advice, sportsy. Never try to put a soul back into a corpse.
Never try to put a soul back into a corpse.
Especially not over and over again.
Especially not over and over again.
Well,
if I ever get my soul back, I'll keep that in mind.
For the longest time, I always wondered, why don't doggos do this? I know now. Years and years of clinging onto my own dead body has caused my soul to rot and tear itself apart.
Okay, clinging onto your own dead body, what are you talking about?
The more reasonable side of me has retreated here.
So the side that doesn't kill kids for fun.
More or less.
Wait a minute, so he's normal and he's just crazy and that's how he was doing all that crazy shit? What about the other part of your soul?
I have no clue where my feral side
is. His feral side.
It's still out there, I bet. It usually comes back. It always does.
Wait, are there any other alive people here aside from us?
No, other than us, there's only stray souls hanging around here.
Oh, great.
But then again, I'm not exactly sure if I'm what you'd call alive. And we ain't neither.
Actually, we're not alive?
That's exactly why you're able to move between the flip side and reality.
What do you mean?
The flip side is a place for souls to physically move around. If a normal human ever tried to enter here, through the glass of that arcade machine, their old soul would push back against the glass.
Okay.
Like a reflection on the other end of a mirror. Without a soul, nothing can push you back through the glass.
Uh-huh.
You can come and go as you please. Interesting.
That is interesting. Okay.
I haven't really kept up to date on what's going on in reality. I last checked out around the early 90s. Granted, I could easily take a gander at what reality Dave sees.
Okay, what does Dave see? Can you do that for me right now?
Let me check.
Oh, he's checking.
Okay, I see darkness.
Darkness.
Okay, I think I'm eating a kebab.
In the dark. I gathered.
You know, it's actually quite fortunate that you decided to come here tonight. Something eerie has happened.
Uh-oh.
Do you remember the real Fred Bear?
Yes. I swore a promise to that very bear.
Good, good. Anyway, he went fucking AWOL.
He went AWOL. Pardon?
Well, being a non-literal entity, he spent quite a lot of time here with the lost souls. Watching reality, waiting for the right time to jump in and fight evil.
Oh boy.
What? He hasn't been seen here in quite a while. He left one bay and never returned. I don't know what exactly went down in reality. What? Something bad clearly happened to the Fred Bear.
Oh shit.
This place has been extra screwed up since then.
I see. Perhaps I should get going then, or what have you been occupying yourself with lately?
I've tuned about 335 guitars, made a few dozen pizzas, rugby tackled the robots at least once. I'm just really bored, to be honest. Say, if you're going, perhaps I could join you.
Yes, please.
I could use a friend here.
Maybe I could be that friend.
I'd like that. Sportsy.
Sportsy.
I'd like that a hell of a lot. Think about it. You have some kind of quest to go on. I'm bored enough to do
whatever painful task you set me to do.
It's a win-win situation. Besides, there's robots afoot. You're gonna want me around to help fight them off, right?
Yes. Fight them. Okay. Come on, Dave, show me the fuck around this godforsaken place.
Oh, this is gonna be so much fun. It'll be like a slumber party, except we're fighting 7-foot tall animal robots and searching for dead people.
Oh, great. You can now explore the Flipside with Dave. Interact with props and scenery to hear some exclusive commentary. So you know what we're going to do? We're going to save, and I'm going to call this the end of part 1 of Dayshift at Freddy's 3. Just save that. Alright, so this has been the first part of Dayshift at Freddy's 3. If you like this video, if you think it's different than the other two games, but if you're a fan anyway, hop on over to that like button and you know what to do. And of course, if you haven't, subscribe. And remember to hit that bell button so that you know when the next video goes live. And thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.